Good day, students. We are in the second lecture in the costing for weaving industry. Rather than putting it as weaving industry, if it is put as woven fabric, then it would be more apt. So I have put as costing for woven fabric. In this lecture, we are going to see the calculations related to GSM and the yarn requirements. Yarn requirements for warp and weft yarn needed for a woven fabric. We are going to look into a plain woven fabric and a striped fabric in this lecture. So, as you all know, the warp yarn is the yarn which is parallel to the selvage of the fabric. When you take the selvage of the fabric, say the fabric is like this, then this is the selvage and the threads that are parallel to the selvage is the warp thread. Okay, parallel to the this selvage is the warp thread and this perpendicular one is the weft thread here in this fabric. So in this picture you can see the green color one which is parallel to the selvage is the warp thread and the red line is the weft thread. Just the representation of the fabric. The fabric which is shown here is a plain fabric, one up and one down. So let us look into the yarn requirements, warp yarn and weft yarn requirement calculations and also the calculation for the GSM. So this fabric weight is expressed in GSM. The fabric weight may be expressed in GSM, which is the SI unit. GSM means grams per square meter, or the fabric weight may also be expressed in ounces per square yard. But the SI system is GSM and it is commonly followed, and in India GSM is followed. When the fabric is available, when you have the fabric, you can just go take the width and length and weigh the fabric, or you can take a small swatch of 10 into 10 centimeter, put the weight of that fabric and find the GSM by multiplying the weight of the 10 by 10 centimeter swatch in grams into 100. When you multiply this into 100, you get the into meter. So in your GSM cutter, you have an area of 100 centimeter square. So you multiply by 100 and get the weight in GSM. When the fabric is not available with you, in some cases when it is happening, you should have the various fabric parameters. So the way fabric parameters like yarn count, set, fabric set, that is EPA, PPA, and the crimp, warp crimp and weft crimp are required to find the GSM of the fabric when you do not have the fabric swatch. So let us see an example where we have the fabric particulars and we need to calculate the GSM of the fabric. We shall also understand the formula through this lecture so that we can use the same formula wherever required. So we have the warp yarn and it is highlighted in red color, the details, and the weft yarn particulars are highlighted in blue color. Warp yarn, the count is 20 ticks and the EP ends per centimeter, not ends per inch, ends per centimeter is given here. It is 30 ends per centimeter. Weft yarn, ticks is 21 and picks per centimeter is 26 and the crimp percentage is 9. Okay, so three particulars are given. Warp crimp is 3%. So let us first look into the warp yarn calculations. For the warp yarn, the ends per meter we have to calculate first, which is ends per centimeter into 100. Ends per centimeter is already given, which is 35. 35 into 100, you get 3500 ends. So the in a meter of fabric, if you take, there are 3500 ends totally. The total ends are 3500 in the total width of the fabric, not in the total width, the width of 1 meter, because we are calculating the grams per square meter. So we are taking the width as 1 meter and also the length as 1 meter. Next is pigs per meter. The pigs per meter is equal to pigs per centimeter into 100. To convert it into pigs per meter, so 30 into 100, we get 3000 pigs for a meter. Next, let us calculate the length of warp per square meter of fabric. The length of warp per square meter is ends per meter into 1 plus warp crimp by 100 into 1 because it is 1 meter. Length of warp per square meter is equal to 3500 ends per meter. We have already calculated into 1 plus 3 by 100. 3 is the warp crimp percentage. Usually, the warp crimp will be higher and the weft crimp will be lower. In this example, it is not so. It is warp crimp is lower and weft crimp is higher. So, we have here 3500 into 103 by 100. 3605 meters of warp are present in length is present in 1 square meter of fabric. Next, let us go into the length of weft per square meter, which is equal to pigs per meter into weft crimp percentage divided by 100 into 1, which is the as it is 1 square meter of fabric. Pigs per meter is equal to 3000. Weft crimp is 9%. So it is 3000 into 109 by 100, 3270 meters of weft yarn is there in 1 square meter of fabric. So now we have calculated length of warp and length of weft. Next is the calculation for weight of warp and weight of weft. Weight of warp per square meter is equal to warp length in meter into warp count in ticks divided by 1000. As ticks is grams per 1000 meters and the warp length is given in meters, we are dividing by 1000. Warp length in meters is 3605 into warp count is 20. So, 20 by 1000, we get 72.1 grams of warp in 1 square meter of fabric. Next is weight of weft per square meter. It is length of weft in meters into weft count in ticks divided by 1000. 3270 is the warp length in meters into 21 is the weft count in ticks divided by 1000. So it is 68.67 grams of weft present in 1 square meter of fabric. So GSM is equal to weight of warp plus weight of weft in 1 square meter of fabric. So it is 72.1 plus 68.67. So it is 140.77 GSM. So this is the overall calculation which we have seen. Length of warp, length of weft, weight of warp, weight of weft and GSM. So we can convert this into a formula for the same problem. This is the formula. So we have ends per centimeter into 100 into 1 plus crimp percentage divided by 100 into warp count in ticks divided by 1000. So we are simplifying the formula. If the ends per centimeter, crimp percentage and count is given in ticks. So this is the formula to find, and using the same we can find the weight of the warp. Similarly, we can use this formula. Using the various steps, this formula is derived. The formula for weight of weft per square meter in grams is pigs per centimeter into 100 plus crimp percentage into weft count in ticks divided by 1000. So we have arrived at the formula using the various steps for length and weight calculation. So this is how we find the weight of the weft per square meter in grams. And finally, the GSM of the fabric, weight of warp plus weight of weft, we can calculate like this. So, for yarn requirements, separate formula for weight of warp, weight of weft and GSM is weight of warp plus weight of weft. So, we have to find out separately for warp and weft to know the yarn requirements. If we need to calculate only the GSM, we can have it to total single formula to find the GSM. But for yarn requirements, as warp and weft are different, we have to use these two formulas. Next, let us look into a problem wherein the fabric is a striped fabric with plain and satin sections. In the stripe, we have plain and satin sections, and the weft is common. So, we have three types. In the warp, we have two, plain and satin, and the weft. So, we have to do three different type of calculations. And before that, we need to find the repeat. So, here in this problem, there are the plain sections. Warp takes for the plain, ends of plain in the repeat, number of ends in the repeat, and the crimp of the plain. Plain section, that is one up, one down, is given. Next, we have the satin in the warp. So, the satin area contains 12 ticks yarn and 72 ends in the repeat. Per repeat, you have 72 ends for satin, and you have 5% of crimp for the satin weave. The crimp is different for satin and the plain weave for the warp yarn. And next, for the repeat, how many repeats are there? We have in the question, there are 40 repeats in the total width. So, per meter and total, we can calculate using this 40 repeats and the width of the fabric. And next is details related to weft. It is similar to the earlier problem. So, weft yarn takes picks per centimeter and weft crimp is given. So, this problem has to be approached like this. You have to find the number of pattern repeats per meter. So, the total width is given. So, per meter has to be found out. Then, warp yarn weight is to be calculated. For warp yarn weight calculation, you have to find the weight of plain weave warp and weight of warp for the satin weave, for which you have to calculate the mass of the plain weave ends, mass of satin weave ends. So, this is related to warp calculation, and next is weft weight calculation, and then the total weight calculation. So, for the warp end calculation, you need to find the number of ends for the plain weave and then the number of ends for the satin weave, and number of weight of plain weave and weight of satin weave ends alone. Both are for warp, and then the weft weight, and then finally the total weight of fabric. So, for this, these are the formulas you can use for the various calculations for the number of repeats per meter. It is total number of repeats divided by fabric width has to be given, because it is stripe. So, we are calculating for the repeat for the width of the fabric. And next, the formula for the number of plain weave ends per meter and mass of plain weave ends per meter. And next is number of satin weave ends divide next and the next is mass of satin weave ends per meter. So, these are the formulas. The formulas are similar for the mass calculation. For the ends alone, you have the number of repeats and the number of ends per repeat is to be find. For that, we have to find the number of n repeats per meter before that. So, let us go into the calculations. First is the number of pattern repeats per meter. So, it is total number of repeats divided by the fabric width in meter. So, in the question, 40 repeats divided by 1.28 is the width of the fabric. So, we get 31.25 repeats per meter. So, the number of repeats can be used for the number of ends calculation. Plain ends is equal to number of repeats into number of ends per repeat is already given in the question. So, it is 48. Next is weight of plain weave ends per meter. Ends per meter of plain weave, which is this one, 31.28 into crimp into warp count per index divided by 1000. So, this we substitute for the values and we get the weight to be 40.5 grams. Next is number of satin weave ends per meter, that is number of repeats into number of ends per repeat. After the number of satin weave ends per meter calculation, we go into the mass of satin weave ends per meter, which is equal to ends per meter, satin ends per meter into 100 plus crimp percentage in the satin area into warp count index for the satin weave. So it is 31.25 into 72 into 100 plus 5 by 100 into 12 by 100. 12 is the index. So we get 28.4 gram of warp weight for the satin area. So we have now calculated the number of pattern repeats per meter, mass of plain weave ends per meter, mass of satin weave ends per meter. So totally the total of plain and satin ends are the weight of the total warp ends in 1 square meter of fabric. Next let us go into the weft yarn calculation. So it is similar to the earlier calculations. Weft yarn, weight of weft yarn per meter is equal to picks per meter into 100 plus crimp percentage by 100 into weft count into 10 by 1000. 28 into 100 for picks per meter, because picks per centimeter is given 28, so into 100 we get picks per meter into 106 by 100 into 14 by 100 we get 41.6 grams. So finally we find the weight of the fabric is equal to plain warp weight, satin warp weight divided plus weft weight. So we get the total weight to be 110.5 grams per meter. So with this we have seen the calculations for a plain weave and a striped one, GSM and warp and weft yarn requirement calculations. Thank you.